Blog Talk Radio.
And welcome to the Bellows. Welcome aboard. It is Saturday morning. It's not just any Saturday morning. It is the Saturday morning that you have chosen to listen to the Balance live all across the United States. Welcome to all of our affiliate radio stations. And also, if you're just happen to find us on the podcast, thank you for downloading the podcast. Hit subscribe so that you know that we're there every single time that we're there. And just by the way, just for the FYI, there is no editing or cutting for the podcast. The show is the podcast. My name is Tom Mark Vassell, Presidente. 917-889-8516 is our digits. This is the week. This is it, guys. I know all of you guys are playing fantasy football. This is draft, draft, draft. I have three fantasy football drafts this week. Our balanced fantasy football draft is tomorrow. And our keeper league is on Monday. So that's right. Today is going to be mock draft day, our annual mock draft. Super fan Adam Jebedin of the Cleveland Browns joins us. Of course, the Colts play the Browns down at Lucas Oil Stadium, their first home game since last December. So we'll see what happens. They're going to get into the Andrew Luck talk. Yes, there's some nervous Nellies out there, and some of us remain optimistic and pessimistic, so we'll get into that. Ed Kracz, beat writer from Philadelphia Eagles, joins us. Also, next weekend, college football is back, so standing by in our balanced green room is Matthew Embry, WSBT up in South Bend, our official IndyCar contributor. I'm going to talk some IndyCar, but also going to stick around with us for our college football kickoff segment with Rick Riggin. I'm going to tell you what, this show is one show that I'll say it every week. You don't want to miss it because I'm going to tell you what, it's about to get good. We'll be right back right here on the Balance Radio Network.
Tonight.
The Air National Guard is a reserve component of the United States Air Force and serves alongside active duty Air Force members in times of a national crisis. In addition, the Air Guard serves the state and local community in a wide range of capacities. The reason people join the Air Guard is as diverse as our members and includes such reasons as a deep desire to serve their country, money for college, travel, new job skills, and the pride that goes along with belonging to the greatest military organization in the world. I joined because I felt a calling to serve my country, but I didn't want to be far away from my family, so the Indiana Air National Guard was a perfect fit for me. With over 95 different career opportunities to choose from and 100% paid college tuition to any state-funded college, why not give us a call? Call 1-800-841-3103 or visit online at goang.com to find out more. Again, that's 1-800-841-3103. The Air National Guard, guarding America, defending freedom.
It's double trouble, double the fun. At African Safari Wildlife Park in Port Clinton, Ohio, see the largest antelope on Earth, the giant eland, and the ugliest creature on Earth, the African warthog. There's so much to see and do, including the Midwest's only drive-through safari. Feed the animals, see live educational shows, feel the excitement. Have your picture taken with a python or cockatoo. Feel the adventure. Shop the Symbol Lodge gift shop with items available from around the globe. Visit the snack bar or picnic facilities. Enjoy a pony or camel ride. Or cheer your favorite porker on to victory in the famous pork chop down. Bring your family to see the rare and exotic animals at African Safari Wildlife Park in Port Clinton, Ohio. Just take Route 2 to the Route 53 North exit and follow the sign. Only 17 miles west of Cedar Point via Route 6. Open every day, rain or shine.
When you don't go to Geico.com, car insurance can be confusing. Like Swedish techno confusing.
Bark, bark, meow, meow. Dance with me, purple cow. Bark, bark, meow, meow. Ooh, you lovely cow.
Geico makes it easy. With 24/7 access, all you have to do is go to Geico.com and you could save money on car insurance. It just makes sense. Unlike, you know.
Dance with me, purple cow. I like your move.
When you don't go to Geico.com, car insurance can be hard. Like early 90s heavy metal hard.
I'm yelling and screaming and I'm loud. Roar.
Geico makes it easy. You can review and update your policy or report a claim on Geico.com or the Geico mobile app. Because shouldn't we all have a little less stress in our lives?
I'm not even upset about anything.
Welcome back to The Balance. My name is Tom Marcus, El Presidente. It is time to kick things off. Joining us right now is Matthew Embry, WSBT in South Bend, our official IndyCar contributor. Also loves to talk college football with us as well. Welcome aboard, Matthew. How are you?
It's funny how things are getting so close to football season. I mean, we're just 1 week away from the start of high school football season. Notre Dame gets going on September the 2nd on Labor Day, so lot to look forward to, but there's a lot of unanswered questions as well.
Oh, absolutely. Well, one of the big headlines of the week, and we certainly want to talk about this, Dale Jr., Dale Earnhardt Jr., maybe you've heard, maybe you haven't heard, plane crash landing there in Tennessee just outside of Bristol, was going out there to do coverage for the Bristol race, which is tonight going to be a big race. Well, we could touch on that a little bit, but really an amazing, if you've not seen the video, I encourage you to go to either our social media, because we had it posted. Speedway Digest has it up there, anywhere up there. But obviously, we encourage you to go to our social media outlets and see the video of this wreck, this crash landing of Dale Earnhardt. Dale Earnhardt Jr., his wife, his one-year-old daughter, their Irish Setter, and two pilots escaped by seconds from death. Matthew, go ahead. We're going to give you the chair here and tell us what you know about this crash.
Well, obviously, anytime you think of a plane crash in NASCAR history, obviously you're concerned, because that's how we lost Alan Kulwicki in 93, a plane crash. We lost A.B. Allison, the same deal with the helicopter crash in 93. So it's not a fun thing to talk about. And the good news is we don't have another Earnhardt tragedy like we had several years ago. I think that's the biggest thing out of this, is that we're not going into that thing for the second time around. And for some of the Earnhardt fans who are still getting over, or haven't gotten over, Dale Sr.'s passing, this would have just made it a whole lot worse. So, amen, they were able to go through. But, yeah, I'm sure he's going to be rattled for the next few weeks or months after what happened.
Yeah, absolutely. And he's going to be out of the booth for this weekend's race. They're thinking he'll be back in the booth in September. And, you know, a lot of people are Dale Jr. haters will be haters. And a lot of people thought that he capitalized and got his fame on his dad's name. Well, yeah, it got him in the door. Yeah, it got him notarization. He retired in 2017, one of the greatest. Really, I mean, put him right up there with his dad, and he earned it. He went out there and won races. I mean, he didn't get to win races. He didn't get to win the Daytona 500 just because his dad was Dale Sr. But I tell you what, over the years, I mean, you look at his career, you look at his life, he was a young, we'll say it. I mean, I think he would agree that he was probably a little bit a wild child, if you will, a little wild on the track. But I've seen him mature over the years, and I guess that's one of the good things about being an old man is that I have seen him go from being a young chest-thumping kid to being a very mature, professional broadcaster, father, husband. And, you know, yesterday's stories that are coming out of this is, you know, basically what happened was they pushed their one-year-old daughter out the door. She was trying to come back in. They pushed the dog out so the dog would take off. She went after the dog. Then the wife got out, and he forced the two pilots to get out first, and then they helped him get out. That just shows me some real character with Dale Jr. And say what you want about how he got to where he's at. It is what it is. He had opportunities given to him, and he took advantage of them just like any one of us would have. But I tell you what an amazing story that was. And you just never know what, again, just a normal routine landing just outside of Bristol, Tennessee, as they were getting ready to get ready for the coverage of Bristol this weekend. Just an amazing feat. Any final words on that before we move on there, Matt?
None on that, but I think you still look, doesn't hide the fact that if I look at the career of Dale Earnhardt Jr. as a driver, and I'd say an underachiever. If he had more interest in the other tracks besides Daytona and Talladega, he would have won championships. The problem is he just kept getting into this head that he needed to dominate Daytona and Talladega to be a champion. And unfortunately, those restrictor plate tracks only make up a tiny portion of the season. And if he had taken the other tracks seriously, as opposed to just the restrictor plate tracks, his career record would have been way better than not being able to win a championship.
Yeah, and it goes kind of back to what we were talking about earlier. Obviously, Daytona would be an important place for him to win at, and an important place for him to achieve at. And I can understand why he would put that on his must-do list. Let's move on forward. Of course, we got the Indy 500. We got the IndyCar in Pocono this weekend. And we'll talk to you about a story I brought to your attention. I know you, as you mentioned to me offline, that this is the first time that seasoned drivers have returned and raced this race. But Dario Franchitti will race again for the first time in years. And we'll talk about the race here, and you can give us all the ins and outs of this race. But I wonder, and a lot of people are wondering, and maybe it's because of the name, but Dario Franchitti, is he testing the waters for a future run? I mean, maybe, I don't know, don't think so, but certainly if he's going to maybe come back and maybe play in the same range as Elio Castroneves in the sports car, it doesn't really matter if he's back in IndyCar. If Dario Franchitti is coming back racing, that's big news.
Yeah, but I think this is like a one-time thing. I mean, Goodwood is a place, you know, where the historics and the Hall of Famers come back. I think Jackie Stewart was racing here up until the last few years. Sir Sterling Moss ran here several times after he had retired. So I think this is just a one-time thing. I don't think it's a sign that he's thinking about making a comeback or anything like that. I think this is just one of those, you know, have fun, you know, try to rekindle some of the magic just a little bit, kind of like that Bristol Legends race is. Just hope it doesn't end as ugly as that one did, when we had serious injuries involving Larry Pierce and a few others several years ago. But good to see him back on the track, but I don't think this is a sign that he's coming back to an Indy 500 or an IndyCar ride anytime soon.
Let's get into the IndyCar race. Obviously, IndyCar is in Pocono. We've only got a few more races left, a handful of races. I mean, it is down to the wire. We're still looking at Joseph Newgarden being the champion as we roll into Pocono down there in the mountains of Pennsylvania.
I think right now Joseph Newgarden needs to get results and outpoint Rossi in these next two oval races, because if he does not outpoint him at Pocono or Gateway, I think it's advantage Rossi, because I think the last two tracks, Laguna Seca and also the closer, Portland, another one as well, and then et cetera, I think those are tracks where Rossi's going to have the advantage. So I think if Newgarden does not get it done here, he certainly sets himself to possibly losing the championship to Alexander Rossi. And then for Simon Pagenaud, he's got to win this race, I think, this weekend and have a good result at Gateway to have any chance to make.